Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the new SAT Math section. This is problem number 15, practice test 4, section 3, no calculator, found in the new SAT official study guide. Okay, so x squared minus 2 times x divided by 2 is equal to 2 times p. In the quadratic equation above, k and p are constants. What are the solutions for x? Right, so you have to rewrite it, this equation, in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c, right, where a, b, and c are constants. And then we're gonna use the quadratic formula to solve for x, right? So we rewrite the given equation and bring the 2p on the left side, so you're gonna subtract 2p on both sides, right? So you're gonna have x squared minus 2kx divided by 2 minus 2p is equal to 0. So now we will determine our constants, right? The constant a, because this is in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c, right? So we have to determine our constants in order to plug them in correctly into the quadratic formula, right? So a is going to be 1, because a is next to is the coefficient to the x squared, right? So a is equal to 1. Now b is the coefficient next to x to the first power, so that means that minus k over 2 is b, right? Is the value of b, the constant. And the value of c, the third constant, is simply minus 2p, because this thing is a c, right? Plus c is equal to 0, so c must be minus 2p. Now we're ready to use the quadratic formula. Right, and as you know, the quadratic formula is going to be x is equal to minus b, negative b, you negate the b, and plus minus, and then radical, the square root, inside the square root, b squared minus 4 times a times c, square root closed, and this whole thing divided by 2 times the value of a. And as you see here, I've written it here, so minus b is going to be the negative of this, which is going to be k over 2. And remember, the negative b is also divided, finally, by the 2 times a at the end. Make sure that you do not write k over 2 plus minus and then the fraction. It's still part of the fraction. K over 2 is in the numerator, right? So k over 2 plus minus square root. Now b squared, so you square negative k over 2, so you put it inside, then you square it, minus 4 times a, which is 1, times c, which is minus 2p, square root ends, and then this whole thing divided by twice the value of a, right? 2 times 1, which is 2, right? So then, let's see what's going on algebraically, because you need to really simplify it to arrive at one of these four answers here, right? So it's going to be k over 2 plus minus, as usual, right? Nothing changed so far. Now, now this thing, right? The squared minus k over 2 becomes k squared over 4, because negative squared is positive, and the k, it becomes squared, and then 2 becomes squared, so it's 4. So you simply have k squared over 4. Now what does this become? Minus 4 times 1 times negative 2p. That becomes positive as well, because negative and the negative multiplied produces a positive result. And 4 times 1 times 2 is 8, and p is attached, so it's going to be plus 8p, right? Positive 8p. So this is what your square root looks like so far, right? And divided by 2, because 2 times 1 is 2. And then what's going on? We're not done yet, right? We didn't arrive at the form presented in either of the four answer choices, right? So we need to go on simplifying. So k over 2 plus minus. Now, what do we need to do? We need to get rid of this 4 somehow, but we can't get rid of it because 8p is all by itself. So we need to combine these two terms inside the square root into one fraction, right? So how do we do that? We multiply 8 times 4, right? So in order to have the common denominator, you need to find the least common denominator, which is 4, right? So 8 times 4 is 32. So that means that k squared plus 32p, now you're ready to divide it by 4 because you found the LCD, which is 4, right? So k squared plus 32p divided by 4. And now you can get rid of this 4, right? Because remember that a square root of a fraction means the square root of the numerator divided by the square root of the denominator. Okay, so that means that the square root of the square root of the denominator is square root of 4, which is 2. So you take the 4 out, and which is why you'll see what's going on next. Well, first of all, now we kind of isolate the k, the first term by itself, because k over 2 divided by 2, you see these 2's here, they multiply themselves, right? So that means that we have a result k over 4, right? So we put it outside, and now that's very close to one of these answers here. So we know for sure that c and d are wrong, because k over 4 must be the correct first term, right? So k over 4 plus minus. Now remember, we took the 4 out, so we're gonna have a 2 in the denominator, not the numerator, right? Be very careful, because basically what you have is 1 divided by square root of 4, right? Because there's an imaginary 1 multiplying the k squared plus 32p, right? So it's going to be 1 half outside the square root, because the 4 square root of 4 is 2. So it's going to be 1 over 2 times the square root k squared plus 32p, right? Because we took the 4 out, and as a result, we don't have any fraction anymore, right? So it's just k squared plus 32p. Makes life much easier. Now the same thing happens next. These 2's multiply themselves, right? Because this is a fraction, and when you divide the fraction by a number, the fraction's denominator will multiply this number, right? So 2 times 2 here, right? So that becomes k over 4 untouched, right? Because that's the simplest we can go, plus minus square root k squared plus 32p divided by 4, right? Because 2 times 2 is 4. So this is our final answer, and this is as simplified as it gets, right? You can't simplify this further, and you find this, where do you find this? K over 4, so you're one of these answer choices, right? Plus k, so this one is the correct answer. Answer choice B, k squared plus 32p divided by 4 plus minus, k over 4 plus minus square root k squared plus 32p divided by 4.